Jay Gabrielle, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to be filming today because it's been about 3 weeks since I've been in front of the camera, because for those of you who follow me on Instagram, you'll know that I have been back home in England over Christmas and New Year's, and I had the most amazing time. But anyway, I'm so excited for today's review. We're kicking off the new year blonde, of course, because it's my favorite. And by the way, I have so many more blonde wig reviews on the way. So if you're not subscribed and you like blonde wig reviews, definitely hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so that way you can be the first to know when they are live. So today's wig is Bia. Bia is back, ladies. So this one is RCP 797. And so basically, Main Concept have re-released Bia, and they have released her in 24 inches. And this is the unit that I am rocking today. So I actually have original Bia here with me. I still love this unit. I still wear her. And I just thought it would be useful just to have them side by side so that way you can see what the differences are. Obviously, there is one very big difference. So original Bia comes with dark roots, and as you can see, this unit does not. So this one is literally just creamy blonde, whereas Bia was like a something four at the top and then she went into a creamy blonde. The cap construction for both of these units is pretty much the same. They've got that kind of long deep part, they've got two combs on either side of the part, they have adjustable straps, and they have one comb in the back. The only real difference is that with the creamy blonde version that I'm wearing, it's pink, whereas original Bia does have the black, but obviously that's because she's dark rooted.
She is a middle part unit, so if you wear her as a side part, you are going to have the lace shift and you're going to have like a flap on the other side.
The creamy blonde color, as you can see, is just ever so slightly different in the version that I'm wearing, and actually I kind of prefer this one. Bia 24 inches is super, super full. I don't know if it's because she's like longer as well, but she is like so full, to the point where a little bit earlier when I put her on, I felt like a bit of a wild woman. I was like, oh my gosh, like what am I gonna do? So I ran a bit of leave-in conditioner through this unit. It is a synthetic unit, it's not human hair, it's not a human hair mix, it's Futura. But sometimes I find with the leave-in conditioner, it just helps to define the curls a little bit better in synthetic wigs. So that's what I did, and they've kind of come back a little bit more. And I kind of like it. I'm still in two minds whether I should straighten it or not. Let me know if you think I should straighten this unit down below in the comment section, because like I said, I'm still making up my mind. I feel like with this wig, I either need to straighten it or maybe like shear it a little bit, like cut it just to kind of thin it a little bit. So another thing about the re-release of Bia is not only does she come in this different length, but she also comes in some other colors as well. I have had some shedding with this unit, just very minimal, just when I brushed it through originally, and then tangling. There's been a little bit of snagging, but nothing too bad. The texture of this unit is exactly the same as the original Bia, so it is just like a silkier kind of texture. I forgot to say it, but I actually got this unit from Elevate Styles, and I paid $37 for it. If you missed out on the original Bia, then I would say go for it with this unit. If you're not comfortable having the all blonde, you could of course use like some mascara. Some people use Sharpies, like you can use all kinds of things to darken up those roots a little bit more. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I will of course be back with another one very soon, so make sure you hit that subscribe button. Bye guys!